Hey folks, in this video I'm going to be using my expert scientific prowess and comparing two different laser engraving machines. More specifically, the ATEZR P20 Plus and the xTool D1 Pro. Both of these machines are 20 watt machines and they have some really cool features. So I have a whole list of different categories and features that I'd like to compare one to the other. And at the end, we'll have a final breakdown of all of our findings that might help you decide which one might be suited best for your needs. So with that said, let's shoot some freaking laser beams.
All right, so the first thing to do is to put together a super fancy scientific looking spreadsheet where I can record all my findings. I'll be comparing a variety of different aspects of each machine, starting with the packaging that they came in, the assembly process, overall aesthetics, their dimensions, the quality of construction, air assist, the laser modules, performance, offline capabilities, and the available accessories. And lastly, I'll talk about the price of each machine. Okay, so first things first, let's get the ATEZR box opened up and take a peek inside. At first glance, everything looks to be packaged in there quite nicely. Tons of foam. They really made sure that each piece was protected. The manual had some nice color pictures and diagrams that lay out the assembly process quite well. So let's see how smoothly it goes together. So for starters, I wanted to just get everything out of the box and to take a look at what I had. I was pretty impressed because one of the things that they did was to separate all the hardware into little bags that were clearly labeled with which assembly step they go to. That was a nice touch. The frame went together easily enough, and then I can flip it over and add on the feet. I dropped on the X rail, and then I fished in the integrated lead screw and I got that tightened onto the motor. Next, I can put on the laser module itself and get that wired up. Lastly, I pull off the film and I fire the thing up. Once it was connected to my laptop, I could home the machine and then I was good to go. All in all, the assembly went very smoothly. It only took me 30 minutes and I had the whole thing together. As for the overall look of the machine, it's pretty stout. It definitely appears pretty heavy duty, but yet it still has a very polished look. From the touchscreen display on the front of the unit, the stocky rails and the laser module, to the branded air assist pump that sits beside, ATEZR really made a great looking machine. Alright, let's take a look at the xTool now. This box was definitely smaller, so I was wondering if they had ample padding for the pieces within. Once I got the box opened, I was immediately met with two very professional looking packages, one for documentation and the other was for test material. Then I took the top layer off. Wow! Just check out those colors. That red and gold is awesome. This is going to be one sharp looking machine once I get it together. So just as I did with the other, my first goal was to just get everything unpacked and to take a look at what I had. The manual has full color diagrams and pictures, so even a Neanderthal like me could easily get this thing put together. Once the frame was screwed together, I could then add on the pulley for the belt and slide in and tighten the lead screw. After that, some wires got plugged in, the X-rail got fastened onto the brackets, and the laser module got dropped into place. Then I just hit the power switch and it came alive. Compared to the other one, this machine looks smaller, but it has a very smooth and sleek image and the bold colors, they sure set it apart. I like how clean the front and the side faces are, and the X-rail has such a shallow profile. The only thing that really sticks out is the air assist pump. It doesn't even look like it goes with this machine, but it does. Alright, so how would I rank these machines? Well, for packaging, they both did great. I give them both a thumbs up. I had them both assembled in 30 minutes flat, so I generously award each of them 3 flathead screws. And when it comes to aesthetics, the ATEZR is a beefy machine, so I give it 1 cow. And the xTool, with its red and gold and super sleek appearance, I give it 1 Iron Man. Okay, dimensions, how big are these things? Well, for the ATEZR, the working area is 16.9 by 16.9. That's 430 millimeters squared. To measure the max Z height without any risers, I adjusted the laser module to its highest setting, and then I just used my calipers to measure from the surface to the bottom of the laser shroud, and this gave me a reading of 2.9 inches. Next up, the width turned out to be 25 3/8, the depth was 28 7/8, and the overall height of the machine came in about 9 inches tall. I then held the machine and I stepped onto the fat meter, and once I subtracted my own lard, it clocked in at 16 pounds. Alright, let's see how this compares to the xTool. The total work area for this machine is just a bit smaller than the other one. It's 16.9 by 15.4. That works out to be 430 by 390 millimeters. The max Z height is just 2 inches. The width comes in at 23 1/4. The depth at 23 5/8. And the overall height is just 7.5 inches. And on the scale, the xTool weighed in at 11 pounds. So how do they compare to one another? Well, the ATEZR is just bigger in every dimension measured. It's sort of like the Arnold Schwarzenegger of the two.
Come on, we got to go.
And the xTool, smaller, sleeker, it's like the Matthew McConaughey.
All right.
Okay, so next is the overall construction of the machines. Both machines have braided harnesses for their cables and wires, which keep things looking really nice and tidy. That's definitely a win for each of them. Also, both of them have belt tightening screws on the outside of the machine. This makes it very easy and convenient to make adjustments without having to dig around on the inside. Another thing they both utilize is the integral lead screw. This replaces the coupler that other machines use, which can be prone to issues. But I really like the large, stable feet that the ATEZR machine has. It's also the only one of the two that has an emergency power-off button, as well as a touchscreen display. It does have the older-style push-button limit switches, though, which work. They're just not as fancy as the new brake beam-style switches that the xTool has. There's a tiny beam that gets interrupted to make the signal, so there's actually no contact at all, nothing to wear out over time. The xTool also uses all steel rails and rollers for an ultra-smooth motion and a much longer lifespan compared to machines that use plastic wheels. The xTool also has a flame detection sensor, as well as a gyro. It'll automatically turn off the machine in the event of a detection and sound an alarm that'll make you bleed from your ears. Lastly, I really like how the xTool's cables go out the side of the machine, rather than sticking out of the top like the ATEZR. Just a cleaner look, in my opinion. But both machines have fantastic construction and features that the other one doesn't. I'd rank each of them somewhere between the coolness of the helicopter from Airwolf and the Trans Am from Knight Rider. Okay, on to the air assist portion. I'm not gonna lie, the air pump to the xTool really seems like an afterthought. It just doesn't look like it even goes with the machine. Plus, the hose won't even fit onto the pump unless you use some extra parts to jury-rig it together. It's just clumsy. Plus, there's no speed control, and the switch is super close to the plug, so it's very inconvenient to turn it on and off. Depending where you have it plugged in, you'd have to walk back and forth from the outlet to turn it on. Plus, it's not very quiet. The laser module has a custom nozzle with a fitting that comes out the side of the shroud. Once you have it secured in place, you can fish the hose down through a bracket at the top and into the fitting to supply air to the system. The worst thing about it, though, is the hose they give you. It's rigid plastic, so you can't run it in any of your cable management, and it just sort of sticks out and looks weird. Now the ATEZR, they got this part right. Their air assist pump really looks like it goes with the machine. The cool thing is that they give you a power cord splitter, so both the laser and the air pump work off of a single power cord, so it only takes one plug to run everything. There's a power switch and a speed control right there on the top, so that you can make it virtually silent, or you can really crank it up high. It's really nice. Also, it's all integrated into the design of the laser module. There's nothing external and no corny fittings needed. The hose just plugs right into the top. And speaking of that, the air hose is super pliable. It's like surgical tubing, so you can run it along with all your other cable management and keep things looking real sharp. So what do I think of them? Well, obviously, the ATEZR is the clear winner. I award it 1 stolen walnut board. The xTool, however, that left a lot to be desired. It gets a 2x4 from the home store. Alright, let's talk about the laser modules of each of these machines. The ATEZR P20 Plus adopts a new spot compression technology, and it actually has four separate 6-watt diode lasers which are joined together, and they're compressed into a single laser beam that has a spot that's just 0.08 by 0.06 millimeters in size. To get to the lens of the laser, it's a little fiddly in that you first have to undo two screws that hold on the shroud, then after that you undo two more screws that secure on the nozzle. And then you can push it out of the way and access the lens for cleaning or replacement. Now, when fully assembled, the laser module only has a single window that lets you see what's going on inside. This protects your eyes, but it also makes lining things up before you start your engrave a little tricky. Now, the xTool uses the same spot compression technology, but they use four 5-watt diodes that join together in a beam that has a slightly larger spot measured in at 0.08 by 0.1 millimeters. Now, accessing the lens on the xTool, it's a little bit more simple. Simply release the set screw holding on the nozzle, and that just slides right out. Next, take out a couple screws that secure on the shroud, and there you go. From that point, you can untwist the lens to replace it or for cleaning. But what I want to address real quick is this thing. You know what this is? That's another laser that's used for a set of crosshairs that are tremendously convenient when you're lining up your job. Additionally, the entire laser shroud is see-through, so that it also helps when you just want to see what's going on. Really, both lasers are pretty awesome. How awesome? Well, I'd put them somewhere between the awesomeness of Richard Dean Anderson's mullet and Bob Ross's afro. Alright, now let's test the performance of these things and see how they do. To start off, I'm using some plywood that is exactly 1/8 of an inch thick. Then, because I still had the xTool set up, I decided to start with that one first. I used a test pattern that I downloaded and essentially engraved a bunch of little squares all at different speeds and laser intensities and different number of passes. When it was done, some of the engravings were so deep that it actually cut all the way through. Now, this gives me a good understanding of just how much power I need to do a full cut versus just an engraving in this material. Then I set up the ATEZR laser again and did the exact same test. I noticed that sometimes the air assist actually blew the little squares up onto the surface once they were cut out. In the end, both machines performed just about the same. There were some small variances in which squares got cut out, but that was mainly due to inconsistencies in the plywood. Next, I doubled the thickness and I used a 1/4 inch thick solid poplar. And wouldn't you know it, both machines performed absolutely identical to one another. Then I used the laser to do single pass cutouts of a 1/4 inch material just to see how cleanly and efficiently it could do it. And the ATEZR made short work of it. It had no problem blasting all the way through in a single pass. Plus, the cut lines were super crisp and it left no char on the inside. I did the same test with the xTool, man. Just as you might have guessed, it performed exactly the same and had no problem with it whatsoever. Next up, I performed an engraving test, just to see how well each laser could shade on the material by reducing its laser power. And again, when comparing both the results, they were identical. Then I wanted to test accuracy, as well as how fine the laser spot could engrave. Just take a look at how tiny these lasers can engrave some text. Wow. I had a little bar of aluminum, copper, brass, and steel, and I wanted to see if the laser would be able to etch anything onto them. Well, they both did nothing to the aluminum since it wasn't anodized. They left very, very faint markings on both the copper and the brass, but check out what they did to the steel. They etched into the stainless steel so well. So naturally, I brought the laser over to my neighbor's garage, plopped it down on the hood of his car, and burned in my logo. Oh, it came out so well. Man, he's gonna love that. Okay, so for performance-wise, where should I rank these lasers? Well, after some thought, I probably rank them somewhere between the laser from James Bond's Goldfinger and the laser from Congo. Yeah, that sounds about right. Alright, offline capabilities. xTool has their own proprietary program called Creative Space. That being said, you can still use other programs like Lightburn, but their program is pretty limited, and it doesn't really have a ton of options, but it does connect over the Wi-Fi to the machine. Once you click the process button, though, it won't actually start processing until you walk over to the machine and hit the button. But then, it performs the job without needing to be attached to your computer. So that's kind of cool. They also have an app for your phone called Laserbox, which I was never able to get to work. I followed all their instructions, and regardless of everything I tried, I could never get my phone to discover the machine. Speaking of phone apps, ATEZR also has an app. This one lets you connect to your machine over Wi-Fi and to use your own files or to create something using the provided interface. Then once you set the desired speed and the laser power, you can send the job over to be executed. What's cool is that you can do the entire thing straight from your phone and you never even have to touch the machine. What's even cooler is that you can adjust the speed and the power on the fly if you wanted to. Another offline capability is using the touchscreen display on the front of the device. This lets you access and process project files that are on the memory card which is inserted into the machine. It makes doing repeatable jobs simple, and it keeps you from having to connect a computer each time. And the display just magically attaches to the front when you're not using it. So both machines have an offline solution, but to be honest, I just don't think I'd ever use them. I mean, it's sort of like my stationary bike or my treadmill. They work, I'll just never use them. Okay, so this leaves accessories. The ATEZR came with all the basic things, some protective eyewear, a short USB cable, a few spare parts and Allen wrenches, a tiny stack of test material, and this metal sheet which is supposed to protect your work surface. Well, it's made from a recycled street sign, which isn't a good material for this, and it warped horribly after the very first use, and it rendered it completely worthless. Now the xTool had all the basics as well, the glasses, the cable. They included a book of various projects you can do, that was neat. And their protective metal sheet was much better. I used the heck out of it, and it never warped at all. Got a little case of spare parts and tools, and then for test material, they really went overboard, and they included a ton of different materials, from acrylics and metal cards and plywood and cork and some cardstock. Now, as for other accessories you can buy, they both offer air assist systems, laser enclosures, extension rails, honeycombs, and rotaries. But xTool has even more to offer, like upgradable laser modules, air purification systems, and even exhaust fans for fume extraction. Furthermore, they have literally hundreds of material options that you can purchase from their website. So when it comes to accessories, the xTool is the clear winner. If the ATEZR laser was your typical squirt gun, then the xTool is the Super Soaker 50. The last thing I want to talk about is the price of each of these machines. Granted, these aren't cheap tools, but ask any laser enthusiast that sells the products they make with their laser, and they'll all tell you the same thing. The return on investment capabilities make the cost something that's very achievable. So let's start with the xTool D1 Pro. The list price is $1,199. Something to consider is that this does not include the air assist, though. That's another $159, which brings the total to $1,358. Now the ATEZR P20 Plus also retails for $1,199. And the cool thing is that it does include the air assist solution, the really nice one. Now as time goes by and new technology comes out, these prices are very likely to drop, so be sure to check their website to see what today's prices are. Also, I have two links for you to use if you're thinking of possibly adding one of these machines to your shop. For the xTool, use tinyurl.com/fs-xtoolD1. And for the ATEZR, use tinyurl.com/fs-ATEZR P20. Both these links can be found in the video description, and you'll be helping out the channel if you make a purchase using either one of them. So thanks.
Well, there you go, folks. Hopefully you've enjoyed this super scientific and in-depth review of both these machines, and who knows, maybe you found it a little bit useful. To be honest, I enjoy both of these machines. I've used each one of them extensively, and I like each one. You honestly cannot go wrong whether you get one or the other. So with that in mind, if you are interested in adding one of them to your shop, be sure that you use the affiliate links previously mentioned in the video. You can also find them in the video description below. Now, not only will you be getting a great machine, but you'll also be helping out the Fisher Shop channel. So with that said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and we'll see you next time. Each of these lasers
Oh, crap.
Ooh, bag of candy. The xTool D1. Why am I doing thumbs up?
Well, it's interesting, but I accidentally mirrored it and flipped it. Whoops, gotta do that again.
Laser graver and machine.
At all. Is it hot? Holy crap, sticks. That's really hot. What? How do I turn it on? Oh, maybe with the power switch.